Good learning. So, okay, let's go this direction here. So what about our team right here, guys?
We learned that my feet are too strong, so I stopped, and it broke this part off.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. But we had to keep it back together, or else it would be like, one person could have that part, they can take a cup to it,
mm-hmm.
and put a ping pong and use it, and put it like, yeah!
Okay, good, so...
And the other person would have the stick part.
Nice. Good. So far what I'm hearing is if you put too much pressure, it breaks. Yeah, so the more pressure, the higher the ball goes.
Mm-hmm.
But too much pressure, what happens?
The stick can break.
Because that will happen 2 times.
Good.
2 times?
What'd you guys learn?
If you put too much pressure,
it'll break the stick.
Yep.
A little of the stick. Like one quarter.
So, we talked about pressure, breaking the stick. If we had to change something about our supplies, what could we change to keep that from happening?
We could use not a stick, but a block of wood.
Or use a brick.
Something that would be stronger, right?
No, but
yeah, because
then you could still...
Metal.
There you go.
It would hurt.
And if you would die, it would break because it's so strong.
And if it was stronger, and you could step on it harder, what would that make the ping pong ball? So we'd be a lot better off using something besides a little skinny paint stick, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Maybe a big yard light paint stick.
Yard there
stick.
You go. What did your team learn?
We learned that more ball that you put, that less farther it goes.
Yeah, but the last one, it goes the most because it's further than the launcher.
That's a good point, because if it's higher up on the stick, then when it goes forward, this part's going to go higher than this part, right? Because it's called trajectory. The trajectory is higher in a bigger arc because it's starting further back. If it's starting lower down, the trajectory is smaller, right?
Good.
And you got some good learning. How about you guys with your quadruple barrel ping pong ball?
If the ping pong ball is farther, then it will go farther
mm-hmm.
because it does...
You got it.
It is.
Mm-hmm. The trajectory?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a big word. But so, now, you guys are making some adjustments on yours. So what kind of adjustment did you make to make yours different and better? Yeah, okay. So what happened when you put the 4 ping pong balls on there instead of just having one? Was there a difference?
Some ping pong balls didn't go that far.
Right, okay.
The fourth one didn't go as far as the first one.
So if you had to add one more thing to that. So you've got the tape, and you've got the paint stick, and you've got the PVC pipe, and you've got the cups, and you've got the ping pong balls. Is there anything else you could have added to your supplies to make that better?
Maybe a harder stick.
Harder stick, yeah. There you go. Good. That definitely would help. What'd you guys learn? Now, did anybody notice any difference between... Let me see your PVC. Can I see your PVC? So, did anybody notice any difference about if I had the cup here? Here, let me borrow yours. Yours is taped on, so...
Here.
Anybody notice the difference if you had the cups all the way down and only a little bit of stick on this end versus having the cups... closer and the stick all the way over here? Did anybody notice a difference if you did that?
Yeah, it went further.
Went further how? Like this or like this?
If you put it closer to the...
You put the end closer? Like this? Or kind of like that?
If you put it like...
Show me on yours.
Right here.
Okay. it will make a difference where the pivot. I think fulcrum is the word, right? Been a long time back, excuse me. If where the pivot point is, it will make a difference how far it goes if the where your board sits on the pivot point.
Good. Nope. This was from
Thank you.
All right. What do you guys learn on your teams?
We learned that if you push too hard on
then
the stick will break.
I saw a lot of broken sticks.
Yeah, that's
I think you guys like that part of it a lot better.
Yeah.
Not that much, but
Yeah, well, I think I saw a lot of broken sticks, so that's all right.
Yeah.
So, okay, so what did you guys learn?
We broke the stick.
Yeah.
After
a few times. Yeah, so what would you do different to not break the stick next time?
Not put too much pressure.
There you go. Yeah, because you probably still launch the ball and have the stick for next time, right? Because you think about it, NASA, they spend the Orion Rex. They spent over $800 million on that satellite, right?
Whoa!
So they've got to test and test and test and test because they spent $800 million.
And they break it, they probably can't.
Yeah, they can't just make another one and get another $800 million. So all these kind of tests are what the scientists do to make sure that when they make the final one, because these are all kind of like your prototypes, right? If you're designing, you know, a catapult, which is what we're doing here, and you wanted to make a really good one, you would start off practicing like this and making a prototype, you know, a practice one. And you make all your prototypes, and then when you get the best design, the greatest design is going to work the best, then you spend your $800 million and you build the one that's actually going to go and do the job for you.
This one's about $8, the other one's about $800.
Yeah, a little bit different, huh? Alright, so what did our team here learn, guys?
They learned if you put the stick kind of like closer, it will make it go farther and more speed to it.
And the back one makes it go farther, and this one drops first, then this one drops second.
Definitely.
And this one goes farther.
So I'm gonna save this question for my last team. So if we're shooting the ping pong balls, you think the ping pong ball is going to travel further if it lands in the blacktop, or you think it's going to travel further if it lands in the grass?
Blacktop.
Why is that?
Because it's a flat surface.
Yeah. Exactly.
If it bounces off of it, it will go. But the grass it's really soft, so if you bounce
So why would that be an important thing to think about if you're landing a spaceship or a satellite on an asteroid? Think about your ping pong ball being a satellite, and you had to land on an asteroid or a planet, or it was a spaceship that had to land. Why would that be important to think about?
Yeah, it would be important because if you don't know, maybe it can bounce off something that where you want it to land.
Yeah, if you land it somewhere hard, you got to slow down a little bit, right?
Yeah,
and
but
if you land on a soft surface,
in this space, then it will
slow down.
Land on our grass.
Yeah.
So you have to I don't know how you would do it, but you have to find
the soft
surface so you can bounce it on, like
a trampoline.
But you don't want it to go in the water or you could might just fall in the water.
Well, and that's important. That's what the Mars rover right now on Mars, they're mapping the planet. That's kind of what they're doing. They're getting an idea, okay, what part of the planet's hard, what part of it's soft, where is it flat, where would be the best place.